is that with regards to the love of Allah, then lose interest in attaining the highest stages of rank and you know, pomp and glitter and glamour of the world. Lose interest in attaining that much, obviously, if that's in a moderate way, after hard work and the person gets that, that is something which Allah has given the person. What he's referring to is a person whose night and day becomes totally engrossed only in attaining the dunya. Night and day, somehow or the other, things have to be different. And in the process, he forgets about Allah, his Rasul, his people around him, family. Nobody has a chance in his life. So lose interest in attaining the highest stages of the world, of that state which will make you unmindful of Allah. Automatically Allah will love you. And the second portion, lose interest in what's going on in people's possessions. Lose interest in what's going on in people's lives, people will automatically love and respect you. SubhanAllah. So this hadith should be from those hadiths also which I had put aside. But don't forget this hadith, that a person, I want to become the beloved of Allah. You know what, I need to put aside time in my busy schedule when we have so much time for everything else. How much of my time I'm actually giving to my masjid? How much of my time I'm actually giving for my self-purification and my own self-improvement? How much of tilawah, how much of adhkar, etc., etc. And we will find there's lots of room for improvement, inshallah. The third hadith says, in which we are mentioning the success and the good character of a person comes out. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, narrated by Abu Hurairah, narrated by Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Sahih Bukhari narration. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, O city, could you give me some advice? Similar to the other hadith, give me some advice. Rasulullah ﷺ looked at that person. That person might have had a reputation for being somebody with a short temper, right? Or either way, Rasulullah ﷺ told him, لا تغضب. Don't get angry all the time. Don't get angry. And so he said, okay, jazakallah khair, give me some more advice. He said, you know, لا تغضب, don't get angry. فَرَدَّدَ مِرَارًا, so he kept repeating and saying, give me some more advice. He said, لا تغضب, that suffices for you. And he didn't give him more advice. And to come to think of it, whether that person had a short temper or not, that's immaterial. Because Rasulullah has given him the advice which applies to you and I. And sometimes we say, you know what, Shaykh or so-and-so, give me some advice in this or that. And it's the basics which we forget. It's the very basics in our attitude, in our interactions, which we forget. And so Rasulullah cleaned out that matter and said, you know what, if you control your temper, things, everything else is in place. Control your temper, and then he connects us to the first hadith that a person has to be mindful of his tongue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this is the qualities of the righteous. The qualities of the righteous. Surah Al-Imran, Surah 3, verse 134, 135. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you heard this ayah before, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. The muttaqeen, the righteous, for whom Allah has prepared the best of Jannah, Allah says, they have certain characteristics which make them qualify for the highest abode. And so the first thing he mentioned about them was, يُنْفِقُونَ. So they spend. And they spend it in the way they spend, فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, in good times and in tough times. It's very easy to spend when things are good, but it's tough to spend when there's a pinch in our wallet and things are not going the way we planned or the way we expect. But those who are muttaqun, the way they spend is equal whether they are going through good or bad. That's the first quality. But then the thing I want to bring your attention to, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specified that to get to the highest abode of Jannah after their spending, He mentioned, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ, and there are those who restrain their anger. Kadhm literally in Arabic means to drink up something. Literally means to drink. So it will translate as those who drink up their anger. What it means is a person, the way he drinks water and it goes down his throat, it's not going to come out. So he drinks up his anger, means he suppresses in such a way that it's gone. Because he remembers the ayah, and he takes a step and says, you know what, shaitan is playing with my mind. He suppressed it as if it's not even there. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes it to a level further. Because one thing is to suppress one's anger and maybe be quiet. But the next level is, would you actually forgive that person who you're angry with? Would you actually instantly forgive that person who you have a quarrel with, or you're disputing? Yes or no? If the muttaqoon are the ones who Allah is praising, He says immediately after suppressing, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, and then they also pardon the people. So pardoning is connected to suppression, to suppressing one's anger. Right? It's very, very important. That's the highest level of akhlaq a person can have. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, another hadith has taught us that how a person should manage anger situations. Right? And these are very practical, and you and I, we're all in need of them. In one hadith, a person was arguing with somebody, and his face had become extremely red, his veins were popping out. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to somebody, tell him, just say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim. Because shaitan is adding fuel to that heated situation and say, yeah, you need to stand for yourself, don't back down. And he keeps on saying, he said, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim. Right? That's the first. A second thing, he encouraged us, a person also drinks water. He drinks some water, cold water, and that is also good. That's two. Number three, just move away and do wudu. Just doing wudu and ablution helps the person from the situation. Number four, move away from that situation entirely. That means the ulama have written from the hadith that a person should try to change his posture. Try to change his posture. So if he's standing, if he's sitting, let him sit down. If he's standing, let him sit. If he's sitting, just lie down. And if he's lying down, then just dig a hole in the ground and jump inside. So somehow or the other, he needs to change his posture and move away from that situation. The minute he moves away, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim, drinks water, everything is fine, inshallah, and afterwards he can. But he suppressed the anger, and on top of it, he forgave the person. For the sake of Allah, Wallahu yuhibbul muhsineen, the end of the ayah, and Allah loves those who do good and do ihsan to others. These are three hadith. The fourth hadith, inshallah, will add to the next khutbah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq. Wa akhtar. His anger, and for that, verse 199 you can add also from Surah Al-A'raf, 9th juz, verse 199, also talks of pardoning and ignoring those who are ignorant. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Inshallah, we'll explain that ayah in tonight's program. Otherwise, whatever Allah wills. The fourth hadith is a hadith which talks about wanting and desiring good for all of humanity. Today, we live in a very artificial, superficial, and ostentatious environment where people naturally incline towards fulfilling their own personal desires, their own lifestyle, and not caring naturally for others. And Rasulullah ﷺ said, for a person to be in harmony with those around him, if he cares for others and loves for them what he or her loves for themselves, then this person's iman will then only be complete. The hadith narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, قال Rasulullah ﷺ, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. The highest pinnacle of faith. A person might be calling himself a believer and might be even frequenting the mosque 5 times a day, but if his interactions are weak, if his manners are lacking, right? And on top of that, he's very selfish and he only loves himself. And Rasulullah is saying that person's faith is incomplete. His faith will be complete, and none of you is a complete believer until he or she loves for others what they love for themselves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq and the ability to inculcate these unique teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our life so that we get closer and closer to his mubarak sunnah and seerah. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم انصر الاسلام وانصاره في مشارق الارض ومغاربها. اللهم اجعل بلاد المسلمين امنه مطمئنه من كل افه وذنب وقتل وبليه. ربنا ظلمنا انفسنا وان لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تسمعون.